It was with mixed feelings that I took possession of a family heirloom earlier this year. The ceremonial sword was presented to my great-grandfather John Richardson, who had the distinction of being a Gallipoli veteran and also having fought with the AIF on the Western Front. I first saw this sword as a child and was told it would come to me if I were to join the armed forces, which wasn't to be my path in life. My cousin Chris enlisted, and the second time I saw the sword, it was in his possession. He would go on to leave the army and worked as a security contractor in Iraq and Afghanistan before his sudden death while working in the latter. The phrase, "those who live by the sword die by the sword," has been on my mind since I saw this sword a third time when I received it. While it's not literally the case, I can see that there are decisions which shape our lives, and mine was to become a pacifist when I learned how another of my uncles avoided conscription to Vietnam as a conscientious objector. Otherwise, I wonder if it's possible I would have ended up in the army too. I don't know much about my great-grandfather. I never asked my grandfather about him while he was alive, but my father remembers him as a distant, grumpy figure from his own childhood. I now wonder how he felt, fighting in the disastrous Gallipoli campaign and leading young men to their deaths again in France. Warfare has changed a lot in the last century, and so has the value placed on human life.